The Hungry Poets TV. How y'all doing out there? So let's get it started. Oh man.
Hungry Poets TV. Have you fed your soul today?
Welcome. I don't have any viewers yet anyway. Ooh, what the heck just happened? Hello, welcome back to the Hungry Poets TV. I'm your host, Mika J. Woods, and this is our fifth episode. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I have a great show planned for you guys. Hey, I have a great show planned for you guys today. We have Poetic Boy D in the house. We have a food review for Sounds Delicious Events. We also have a meal of the month presented by Chef Tiffany Hendrix, and I have a special musical guest for you, my girl Sasha L. Henry, who will be performing her hit single called ALOT. So make sure you tune into the whole episode, but let's get it going. We're gonna start today off with our meal of the month presented by Chef Tiffany Hendrix of Sounds Delicious Events.
It's August, that's my birthday month, so it's even more special. I am so excited to bring you this salad. It is one of my favorite salads. It is a quinoa and lamb salad. It has a little Mediterranean twist on it, but what I love about it is that it's packed full of flavor and you feel full after you eat it. A lot of times we eat salad and we're like, I'm still a little bit hungry. This is full with lamb, vegetables. We have some quinoa, so you have a grain in there. You have some acid, lots of herbs. When I tell you, you're going to love this, and you can actually bring this to the barbecue and they won't talk about you when you leave. Let's get started on our lamb quinoa salad.
Here is a look at all of our ingredients for today's salad, but let's get started on the marinade. In a bowl, you want to put some olive oil, chopped garlic, salt, pepper, and then for your aromatics, you want some flat leaf parsley, some fresh thyme, and dried oregano. Now make sure you chop that parsley really fine so that it blends well in your marinade. Then you want to roll a lemon so it's nice and juicy, cut it in half, and then add that juice to your marinade. You need that nice acidity to break down the lamb meat. Then you're going to add your lamb meat to a Ziploc bag. The meat should be cut in about 1.5-inch cubes. Make sure that they're the same size so that they cook nice and evenly. Put the marinade in the bag. Roll it around, roll it around, roll it around. Make sure everything is nice and incorporated. And you're going to let that marinate for at least 30 minutes. The longer, the better. Now we're gonna get started on our quinoa. But instead of using water, we're gonna use vegetable stock. Bring that to a boil and add your washed and drained quinoa. I decided to use tricolor, but you can use whatever suits your fancy. White, black, or red. Be sure to stir it so it doesn't get clumpy and turn your heat down to medium. Let it simmer, and guys, you're gonna cook this just like rice. Watch the liquid reduce, watch the grains swell up, continue to stir so nothing sticks and burns at the bottom. And soon you will have beautiful, fluffy quinoa. Now let's get to the good part. It's time to cook our lamb. If you have a cast iron skillet, I suggest this. In your cast iron skillet, put some oil and some butter. Those bits in there are garlic because I used garlic infused oil. Make sure it's nice and hot. What I love about cast iron is that it seals and it coats and it creates great, great color, but also keeps all the flavor and the juice inside. Take a look at that. Be sure to set the meat aside, but keep the drippings in the pan because we'll use that to saute the red onions for the salad. Let your meat cool, but now let's get back to this quinoa. Look how beautiful and fluffy it is. So I'm adding a couple of things so we can just continue to bring flavor. I added some chopped parsley for color. We eat with our eyes. And then I added a mixture of feta and gorgonzola cheese while the quinoa was still hot. You stir that and you let that creamy cheese melt and really bring some life to your quinoa, and then put it in a bowl and put it in the refrigerator and let it cool completely. Remember guys, we're making a salad, a cold salad. Busted. I stole a scoop, but I was just making sure that all the flavors were on point. We're all set to move on. Let's get to the other components. Now we want to get to our dressing for this salad. The base is going to be some plain Greek yogurt. Then we're going to add our herbs. This time we're adding mint and parsley. Then you want to take the juice of one lemon. Make sure you get all that juice and please strain it so that you don't get any seeds or pits or anything inside of your salad dressing, because we are going to add it to a blender. Once you squeeze all that juice in there, don't mind me, my hands are a little weak. You're going to give it a stir and then add it to a blender so that you can whip it and aerate it and it can be nice and fluffy, kind of like me. Now you want to take your yogurt dressing and add it to your blender. Add some salt and pepper to taste, but not too much. You can always add more, but you can't take away. Give it a good whip, aerate it, and let's get ready to move on to the next thing. Now we're getting to some vegetables, finally, for our salad. So what we're gonna do is add some salt to some diced cucumbers and halved cherry tomatoes. That salt is going to draw the moisture out of those vegetables, and that moisture will help loosen up the salad. Don't forget those red onions. We're gonna saute those in those drippings left over from the lamb. And then we're going to put this salad together. In a bowl, you want to take your cold quinoa and your salted tomatoes and cucumbers, some feta crumbles, and then that beautifully delicious brown lamb meat that is also cooled. You want to add some of that dressing that we've made, not too much. You don't want it to be overdressed. You can always add more for your desired preference, and then give it a good mix. Time to plate it up.
You're going to take your composed salad, put it in a bowl, and then garnish it with some of that reserved meat so you can see that nice brown color. Top it with some more of that feta cheese, and then take some of that fresh mint and just give it a rough rip and sprinkle it on top for some color and aromatics. And ladies and gentlemen, there you have your lamb quinoa salad. Check out my YouTube channel, Sounds Delicious, where you can find more recipes to cook for you, your friends, and your family. It's been real fun cooking with y'all, and I hope that you try this delicious salad. It's great for the summer. Once again, I'm Chef Tiffany of Sounds Delicious, and don't forget to add a little glitz, glamour, and gourmet to every meal. Peace.
Well, honey, wasn't that delicious? Because I know it sounds delicious to me. I'm ready to try this lamb and quinoa salad. It's a little different. It's a little mix up of flavor. Why do I have to eat meatloaf and mashed potatoes every day? This is why I made this show, because I can cook good, but I'm nobody's chef. So I don't really know how to make too many dishes, but I know a lot of chefs. So I'm going to take them, I'm going to promote them, and I'm going to big it up. And everybody's going to eat well now, right? So I just have a few little announcements. We're going to call these church announcements just because, you know, I was raised Christian. I wanted to shout out a very, very young author, Kamala Stevens. She has her first pop-up shop on Saturday in Cambria Heights, on Saturday, August 29th in Cambria Heights. She is promoting her book, My Skin. So please do come out and support her, buy her book, buy her merch. The only way that we can survive is if we do this together, all right? So make sure, and the book is perfect for children, so make sure you check it out, okay? So now that we got that out of the way, also shout out to Escaress Boutique, my cool little swaggy shirt. You know, I got my stomach out, get the butter, because I'm serving rolls. So anyway, also shout out to our new sponsor, Flying Black Unicorns. We are very grateful for you and everything that you've done for us. Now let's get into our guest, because honey, I feel like I might have some tea. I would like to introduce you to this young author. He is amazing. He kind of had this whole Instagram sensation moment during COVID, where he provided open mic space for many poets around the world. And he did this almost every day. And I was looking at him like, this is draining. But each and every day, he made sure that he provided a space for poets to come out and perform and give their work and express themselves throughout the entire pandemic. So ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Poetic Boy D. Come to the stage, Poetic Boy D.
Hello.
Hi, young man.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
That's good. I'm grateful that you are here. Before I even get into the questions, I definitely forgot to shout out what we're drinking today. It is Cloud 929 handcrafted wine. This is the chocolate flavor, because I'm chocolate. And it definitely does taste like chocolate. I had to keep it slow and steady so I can win this race. All right. Thank you, girl. I appreciate that. Now, Poetic Boy D, what are your pronouns? How do you introduce yourself? Let's start there. He, him. Okay. Got to be clear nowadays, you know? I don't want to offend you.
Absolutely.
You could have got up here like, my name on stage is Poetic Boy D, but I see myself as a girl. And I had to respect that.
This is true.
Shoot. I don't cancel me. All right? So, let's start with your name. How did you decide that your name is going to be Poetic Boy D? Because it is simple, but it sends a message.
Okay, so it's not as deep as as you made that sound, man. But honestly, weirdly enough, in high school, I lost a bet to a girlfriend at that time. I was we were playing cards or whatever, and she was like winning like every game. And I'm like, all right, well, I'm gonna win the next one. Like, I was letting you win or whatever. She's like, let's bet. And I'm like, I bet what? She's like, you need to change your Instagram name. So my Instagram name was Eagle. The reason for that is I was a big fan of American Eagle at the time. So I would wear all their stuff.
Okay. Look at that.
Weirdly enough, right?
She's early, like, on sponsorship.
You know, and she's like, yeah, that's, you're too old for that or whatever. You need to change it. You're a poet. Make it something with poetry or whatever like that. And I was like, you know, okay, what about Poetic Boy? And then she's just like, yeah, that works or whatever. And I lost. So I had to change my Instagram name in that moment to Poetic Boy D. And I actually was going by Derek for a long time. And then my friends Anubis and Lucius the King, I was on a rap album with them. First time I ever, like, recorded music. And on the cover art, they had their names, and mine just said Derek.
So plain. So like, simple.
No, we're not putting that there. I'm like, you know, I'm thinking this is me. Like, you know, they're like, but your Instagram name is Poetic Boy D. Like, that's dope. I'm like, nah, but that's not, I don't call myself that. And they kind of pushed me. Like, but people know you as that. You know, so that's what made me actually run with it and make that my name. That's how it actually
Okay. All right. So now we finally understand the mystery behind Poetic Boy D. So, recently you've reached 6,000 followers. Congratulations.
Thank you.
How does it feel? Was that like a personal goal of yours?
Was it a personal goal? Not so much. Like, I've always wanted a following. You know, I've always wanted a following. I'm like, you know, I feel like I do things that people need to see. I want people to see me. I want people to see these things. Like, you know what I mean? I want to share this with more than just, like, my inner circle. You know what I mean? Like, I've always wanted it. Mm-hmm. But I've realized how much more, like, I enjoy interacting with people and, like, the people that are actually supporting me more than the numbers, like, people that genuinely care. I enjoy that so much more. So it wasn't much of a big goal for me. Like, I didn't look at it as much. I was like, that's cool. But it wasn't, like, a big thing, to be honest.
Okay. So now, which one felt better? Becoming an off-Broadway poet or hitting 6,000 followers?
Definitely off-Broadway poet.
Yeah?
Because
tell us about the moment.
Man, I can't even... I'm supposed to be good with words. I can't put it into words. It was... Like, I can't... You know what I mean? Like, it was unbelievable to me because the closest people in my life were there. People that I didn't even meet before from, like, social media were there. They're, like, excited to come out, you know, and we sold that. All right, so it was me and two other artists featuring for Inspired Word, and the venue held 120 tickets, like 120 seats, and I'm over here, I'm like, go big or go home, so I'm like, I want everyone there, like, you know, but I also have to remember there's two other artists that have to sell tickets, you mm-hmm. know. Man, I promise you, about 75, 78 people showed up for me. Wow. And we sold about 89 tickets, I would say, out of, you know, 120. You know, and I was excited and felt bad at the same time. And I was like, man, y'all really came through for me. Like, I pulled up and everyone was in there and the energy was crazy. I had planned out so much for the for the showcase, you know. It was amazing. And then I also felt bad. I was like, man, they didn't sell any tickets. Like, they couldn't because
you sold 7,000. Yeah.
I sold the tickets already. So it felt amazing. Like, I can't put it into words. I'll never forget that.
That's amazing. That is amazing. But you've also had some other really big moments in your career, like your apparel, which really hit big in the poetry community. So what inspired that? How did you get there?
Okay, so I wasn't big on sharing videos at one point. Mm-hmm. Like, my poetry. I was like, come see me in person, or you just don't see me, you know? And then I got over that, and I was like, well, people on the internet might want to share this with people that will never see. So, you know, I got over that. And then I was like, I want people to have something to go home with. Like, I always remember thinking, like, when people go to concerts, you know, you leave with merchandise. You know, you leave with something that would be, you know, something to remind you of that night. So I dropped the first piece of clothing I dropped. It said, I know three commandments, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not cheat.
I remember that, yeah.
Thou shalt not rob me. And that poem kind of took on a life of its own. So when that happened, it was like, okay, you know, why not, you know, give somebody something to go home with? So that was why I first did it. Like, that was why I first did it. And then I realized a lot of people that didn't know the poem wouldn't care for it. You know what I mean? So I was like, well, what can I do next that'll, you know, reach out to more people, that expand my brand and my name. So then Poets of People Too was a thing. Because
I have the pillow Poets of People Too. I was going to bring my pillow, but since I use it, like, often, it's on my bed, it is, yeah, I got to get another pillow. Because I can't even, like, I used to post it in the background of my pictures, like, because I'm a poet and I'm a person, too. But I can't do that now because I use this pillow. It's a comfortable pillow.
That's what it's meant for.
Yeah, you know, I'm not the person that just has throw pillows that you don't use. I use my pillow.
I don't use the pillows in my house. They're there.
I'm not. My mom would be very upset if she saw me, how I lay across my throw pillows.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Hey. Glad to hear it.
Yeah.
You know? Really.
You are a character. So this year, you dropped this wonderful book, Thoughts from April, by Poetic Boy D. You see here with the artwork, as well as your EP.
Yes.
So your momentum is pumping, coming out of COVID. You had all of this momentum, all of these new followers. You had all of this open mic. What's going on? What's getting you here? What brought you to this point?
Okay, so during pandemic last year is when the book was released. And the book was released because I finally had the time to sit down and actually finish everything. Like, you know, I again, as you said earlier, that I got caught up with the lives that took on a life of their own.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that was amazing. But definitely actually, like, took some time off from the lives and was like, well, what am I doing? You know, like, how am I going to continue to be Poetic Boy D? Because performance is my thing. You know what I mean? Like, how is that going to continue? Like, but anyway, I sat down. I went through all the poems that I knew I wanted to be in the book, and I edited them. I'm like, yo, okay, I'm going to reach out to a graphic designer now. I'm going to Google how to actually put it together now. Like, I actually was determined to do it. So doing that, that was huge.
Mm-hmm.
And music, that's something I was working on since 2019, when me and Jay Morris released an album.
I remember that one.
A collab album, yes. So I always had songs that I wanted to put out, so it's been like going on at the same time, but I finally like sat down and set to do it. So the pandemic really, really like pushed me to feel like, you know, I still have to, produce. Like, I still have to give people something, you know what I mean? I still have to let my energy out somehow, you know what I mean?
I feel you.
Definitely.
I feel that. So, in more of your recent work, you discuss a young woman that you are trying to get. Did you get the girl?
Okay. Are we talking about on Instagram?
Because it's on Instagram, it's in your recent work where you talk to the cab driver about this girl. Did you get the girl?
I'm just an artist.
You see, he's pleading the fifth. He's trying to act as if I believe he got the girl.
I don't know. I'm just an artist.
Look at that. Let me find out. He sounds like he a player. Ladies, be careful.
He's gonna leave it there.
Ladies, be careful. No, but as far as your merch, can we look forward to a Poetic Boy D do-rag anytime soon? Because you're not wearing it today, but it's usually like your signature look.
It's definitely become a thing. Hats were my thing, and then I grew my hair during the pandemic and started like braiding it and twisting it and stuff. Not today. Getting done soon. Figure that out. But nah, no do-rags coming.
No do-rags.
I just keep supporting other people.
Well, also, what piece do you feel you have written that has changed your life?
That's an interesting question.
Or affected your life the most, if it hasn't changed it.
Okay. Wow. I should have prepared for that. Okay. I have a poetry piece called Addicted that talks about me being addicted to, like, saving people.
Mm. Oh, you kept to save a home?
Hey, no. I really do often put people before myself. So I feel like I'm such a storyteller, I don't often go back and write about myself. Mm. So I would say that poem definitely was most impactful for me as far as, like, me. Like, as far as, like, letting my real thoughts and feelings show. You know, I feel like that was most impactful. Or there's a song on my first album called Emotional, where I kind of share my thoughts and feelings about my parents and just how I felt when the album was being put together and, like, what was going on with their health and just me being the only child, things like that. That song probably most.
All right. So, this is a real question. This is a question that means a lot to me. How do you feel that poetry can change the world?
I feel as if poetry reminds people to feel. Ooh. And that
it's deep.
We're not the only ones that go through. Like, you know, I can be upset today and I didn't know how to express it. And then I'll hear a poem and I'm like, whoa, that's how I felt. You know what I mean?
Yes.
I feel like the more we consume poetry, it's the better. Like, you know, because some people just numb in this world, you know, but something about poetry can, like, bring you out of that. You hear the right poem, the right poet, the right delivery, the right words, you know. So,
okay, brother man,
that would be mine.
All right, last question. Do you feel like you fed your soul today?
I'm here with you.
Good answer.
Absolutely.
So, ladies and gentlemen, you are going to hear a little bit more from Poetic Boy D after. Oh, thank you, sweetheart. And thank you too, Tara. But you guys are going to hear more from Poetic Boy D after this. Well, next up, we're going to have our review of the Backyard Bistro. All right? It was some good food, but let me let you know how it really was. Check this out.
Backyard Bistro, here with the Hungry Poets TV at the Backyard Bistro with Sounds Delicious Events. Check it out. This is going to be good. We just had our first meal of fruit. Nice environment. Cute table settings. Check out Chef Tiffany, always working. Nice.
And boy, did it get nicer. Next thing we know, she got the bottles popping. She gave us peach Bellinis. Well, we had a choice between mimosas and peach Bellinis, and I have never had a Bellini. So today, I was a Bellini baby, and a peach Bellini was delicious. Thanks, Tiffany. The menu for the Backyard Bistro included the bossed up bacon, egg, and cheese, the do or die bagel, chicken and waffles, the vegan BLT, and the under the sea salad. All menu items came with truffle sea salted fries and a pina colada fruit salad, as I've already shown you. Also with the unlimited mimosas or Bellinis. As I told you, I chose Bellini, so Bellini me baby. Now, I decided to get the chicken and waffle, which I'm gonna show you a picture of that here. But let me let you know, this picture, not even this one, is doing it justice, okay? You have to see how I saw it. It sparkled as it came to my table, honey. Just look at it. Just look. Take a moment. Take that.
Okay, honey. Here is the moment of truth. This is my very first time ever having chicken and waffles. And it looks absolutely delicious. You see that? Look all crunchy and crispity. I'm so excited. Sounds delicious. We're about to see if this is any good. Hey guys, so usually, you know, I start at the start of the meal. Clearly I was hungry. This is delicious and I am not mad at it. If you see, I have like, I'm like halfway through my waffle because I was supposed to start with you guys, but this, I'm not even a fan of waffles, but this has to be one of the best waffles I've ever had. But you see, it's like crunchy, you see that? Ooh, it's crunchy. The chicken is delicious. And then she made me, because I'm allergic to maple, so this really delicious strawberry syrup.
I'm to this strawberry syrup that was absolutely amazing. The chef who made it was Shanika from Shanika's Seafood House. And oh my gosh, the strawberry syrup was to die for. It was like a flavor explosion. Just, you can see in the bottle that it was fresh. All of the ingredients were fresh. It was very homemade. And I am grateful that you took the time to give me something that would have me enjoy your meal just as much without having, without going into anaphylactic shock. I appreciate you.
I'm mad at it. It is one hell of a meal. And I'm over here taking peeks at the next person's meal because they have a bossed up bacon, egg, and cheese. I'll put the photo in here. It's like bacon, egg, and cheese on a waffle with a side of fries. It looks delicious. So yeah, guys, I would love to keep talking to you guys about how amazing this meal is. I'm gonna take one bite on camera because, honey, I just want to eat. I'm starving, and this is worth every bite. So, and I'm afraid that if I keep eating while I am trying to review this food, all y'all are gonna see me do is chew. All right, it's delicious. Mm. All right, go y'all. Catch the rest of the review. I'll send you some. I'll give you guys the info for Sounds Delicious. But I'm gonna eat this beautiful, beautiful brunch. I've already dug into, as you can see. It's delicious. Thank you, Sounds Delicious.
As you can see, I quickly joined the Clean Plate Club. But the real treat came right after we finished eating. She came out with this wonderful birthday cake and did this little ditty for a beautiful birthday lady in the crowd.
To you, happy birthday. To you, happy birthday.
Happy birthday!
After hearing that little number, let me introduce you to Johnson and Wales Culinary School graduate Tiffany Hendrix. Tiffany Hendrix is a chef, a pastor, and an event curator. She specializes in home decor and private dinners. She has created a series of private dinners called Backyard Bistro, as well as brunches and something special called Food for the Fellas. Food for the Fellas is a dinner party that is catered to the special man in your life. I actually got to host one, which was catered to a very cool guy named Keith. Each of his guests had a table setting with their name on a dream car. Some of them had McLarens, some of them had Porsches, some had BMWs, even Ferraris. And it was an amazing experience to see these classic men witness this experience. So you don't have to hear it from me, you can hear it from some of them.
Yeah, baby, I'm enjoying myself here. These little young ladies, my black sisters, having a great dinner. Nothing better than this, what you got. These girls work hard, and they sisters, and I recommend them 1,000,000%. That's cool.
It turned out to be real nice, you know, it was real nice. The food was nice. I'm not complaining, because the food was nice. So, I think it met my expectations. It was a good thing. A lot of smiles, you know what I'm saying? You know, good thing.
All right.
Good thing. Look, I'll be in touch. Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So if you ain't got it yet, let me let you know now why Sounds Delicious is about to get the rating they're about to get. Because not only do they taste delicious, they sound delicious. Right? Hit it, Tiffany. Bah!
Okay. Happy birthday to you.
Okay. Wow.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Dick.
Sounds Delicious Events is exactly where you need to be. And that is exactly why they are getting 5 Whiskey and Ink, 5 Whiskey and Ink, 5 Whiskey.
Have you fed your soul today?
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is why Sounds Delicious Catering got 5 Whiskey and Ink, 5 Whiskey and Ink, 5 Whiskey and Ink. I am so grateful to them for inviting me to the Backyard Bistro. It was delicious. And if I didn't say enough about that strawberry syrup on the thing, like that, it was delicious. Thank you again, Shanika, for meeting my dietary needs. Because your girl is allergic to maple and bananas. I'm just putting that out there in case anybody want to feed me. I'm always here for dinner dates and suggestions. You know a new restaurant, sis? Let's hit it up. I'm always down. If you got a new recipe, send it in the inbox at the Hungry Poets TV. If you have somewhere that you just know needs to be reviewed, especially if it's FUBU, you know, for us, by us, let me know. I will definitely pop up, show up, and show out. I love my people, and I hope my people love me too. But let's move on with the show, all right? So next up, we have a spotlight performance by none other than my favorite poet of this month. And I'm not saying that just because he's on the show. I'm going to say that because he is absolutely amazing. He is just, you know what? I think I have said enough about this wonderful young man. I'm going to let you check him out for yourself. Here's Poetic Poetry.
Don't know how I got here. All I remember seeing is red. All I remember feeling is that everything around me needed to die. All I remember smelling was my blood boiling. And all I remember hearing was a whistling sound that made me feel like a teapot ready to explode. And then I couldn't remember. Everything after that is a blur. What am I doing here? Why is there a needle in my arm? I don't like needles. Why is there a needle in my arm? Is anyone going to answer my questions? I don't understand why I'm in this bed. I don't understand why there's a pounding in my head. It's aching. I'm in this room talking to myself. The nurse finally walks in, and that's when I realize I'm in a hospital and this has something to do with my health. She says, "How do you feel?" I say, "How do you think?" She says, "How do you feel?" I say, "Why am I here?" She says, "You don't remember." I look around, trying to paint a picture in my mind, but I'm drawing nothing but a blank. I say, "No." She says, "We should wait for the doctor so he can let you know." I say, "No."
If you know what the hell is going on, why aren't you telling me? She says she's not the one that should be telling me. I say, what are you telling me? She says, I'm not telling you a thing. I say, to me, the look upon your face is telling. I says, she says, you shouldn't look upon my face. I say, I'll lay this hand upon your face if I have to ask you again. And then the doctor finally walks in. He says, how do you feel? I say, God, does anyone get to the point? Because at this point, I'm not trying to point fingers, but Miss can't keep a straight face over there. It's making me nervous. He says, calm down. Your blood pressure is rising. If you look at the monitor, you'll see it. I say, I don't give a damn. If she was better at monitoring her face, telling me calm down wouldn't be needed. Miss Bad News over there is acting like this is a secret, that her secrets kept secret from her secrets. What the hell is going on? He says he understands me lashing out. He understands that I want to blame her. My blood's boiling. I'm staring at the stranger as his words get stranger. He says he understands that I'm struggling, but needs me to know my life is in danger. I see red again, pissed off at every word he said, and I don't want to hear the remainder. He says, I'm sorry. The symptoms are clear. The news I'm about to break to you is a real life changer. He says, I'm sorry, but you've been diagnosed with a severe disease, and the disease is called anger.
Yes, yes, yes.
Do you have anything else you'd like to share with us,
Dandy?
The stage is yours.
Thank you. I'm like super excited. Glad I was here. You know, this is great. Yeah, if you want to support me in any way, definitely follow me. That's down there, Poetic Boy D, Cash App, you know. Nah, but y'all can check out my merch. That's all I care about right now. Not all I care about, but my merch and my album is the latest thing that I released. It's called... what is it called? Wow, that was crazy. It's called All Because of You. It's on my shirt. You can't read it, but All Because of You. I have merch which has a whole bunch of quotes from the album. And if you don't want to listen to the rap music, check out the book, Thoughts from April. It's on my website, poeticboyd.com. That's all I got for y'all. Appreciate you.
Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up one more time for Poetic Boy D and his spotlight performance. I'm so grateful, so grateful that he came onto this show. I was actually fortunate enough to perform on his IG.
Hello? Can y'all hear me? Hello?
You're good, Sasha.
Okay, I wasn't sure. Yeah, I'm Sasha L. Henry, singer-songwriter. Do I just get it on and pop in? I didn't hear anything you said, so I don't know. Am I waiting on you? Do I take it and go? What you want me to do, sis?
Sis, go on and sing. We ready to hear you.
Oh, snap. All right, say less.
Sis, go on and sing. We ready to hear you.
Oh, snap. All right, say less.
Hey, I don't know what happened to your sound, but we can't hear you.
Can you?
There I am.
Alrighty. Okay, so. Singer-songwriter Sasha L. Henry, based out of Toronto. I'm going to be doing my debut single, A Lot. Hope you like it, because, you know, I'm a lot to lose, as they say. So, yeah, hope you enjoy. Okay, I get it. Heard all this before. You think I'm too much and I think too little is a bore. You met me on stage, now you have said that I'm a star. What did you expect? How did we even get this far? Maybe I'm a lot to take, a lot to stand. Maybe I'm a lot to handle, but ain't you supposed to be my man? Then why don't you understand? You got a big deal on your hands. Shame you never knew. I'm a lot to lose. I'm a lot to lose. I'm a lot to lose. Yeah. I'ma now hold up. Why are you back? If I'm too much, why you need a playback? What's that? You say you miss me, but boy, ain't you like just this me? I'm not a lot, you ain't enough. I'm rum, no chaser. I pack a punch, and we both know you ain't. And thought I was a lot to take. Heard I wasn't allowed to stand. Wasn't I allowed to handle? But now you wanna be my man. I'm allowed to lose. Yeah. I'm allowed to lose. I'm allowed to lose. Ooh, yeah. Ooh. To pass up a lot to forget. Look what they got you, now you upset. You tried, but I could have bet you would be back full of regret. Now I gotta ask you, please keep the same energy. Ain't no coming back to me. It's far too late to see. I'm a lot to lose, yeah. I'm a lot to lose. Baby, I'm a lot to lose. Can't nobody fill my shoes. Baby, I am one of you. Shame you never, shame you never knew. No, 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 no. Shame you never knew. No, 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 no. So you just want somebody to sit there, look cute, and be quiet. That's crazy. You better get you a dog or something. You better get you a labradoodle. Maz don't even know what a labradoodle look like, but I know you better get you one. That's crazy. You want a trophy wife. But what you want a trophy for, boo? Being trash? Boy, bang. You better get out of here. So yeah, that's A Lot, my debut single.
That was dope, and you are hilarious. You are hilarious. I love that part you said. Boy, you want a trophy? Bye. I was listening to this song often. I was over here singing in the background. I'm not a singer, so we're not gonna. I'm not gonna embarrass you and ruin your song on live. Okay.
It's all right. I'm not a poet.
In the shower, though.
That's love. That's love. Thank you. Thank you so much.
I appreciate you for coming out. I thank you so much. Guys, she's tuning in all the way from Toronto. Your girl got an international talk show. All the ratchet came out. All the ratchet. Don't judge.
As it should. As it should.
I'm international. You're
hilarious.
I turn shoulders on that one. You know? No, but thank you so much, Sasha. You are amazing. Your voice is like silk. I've told you that on Instagram. I found this girl on a Clubhouse, okay?
Yeah.
Because your girl be networking. If you know me, you know I'm a networker. And I found her on Clubhouse, and she is amazing. She's singing live on Clubhouse, and I was like, nah, this is the radio. She playing. Her voice is silky. I love it. It's beautiful. Shout out to the real crooners like you and Tiffany. I'm grateful to know you, beautiful woman. Mwah. Yes. Yes, honey.
Thank you.
But I gotta let Sasha go. I ain't gonna keep her too long. Make sure you support her. Download her music. It is available on all platforms. I already have it. So if you want me to send you the link, just text me. I'll send you the link. All right?
All right. Thank you, Sasha.
Thank you, Sasha. Would you like to say anything else to the audience?
Follow me on everything, Sasha L. Henry. I have an EP coming out in like a month and a half. So keep your eye out for that. You see what I'm saying?
Yes. All right, y'all. We'll talk to Sasha later.
Thanks. Bye.
Thank you again. Guys, now y'all know that that was fire. You know that was fire. Okay? I'm so grateful to her for coming on. I'm so grateful to have had her on this show and share her beautiful, silky voice with us. And unfortunately, we are just about that time. We are closing in on the hour. And you know how I like to end off with a poem of my own, right? So, guys, this one, look, just y'all know me, okay? You know me. So, just bear with me. All right, I'm a work in progress. This one is called Wishes for Love, okay? I'm tired of dating. Can't you tell? I just want someone to love me. I used to love love. Then I became happy being the side chick because we all know that she gets treated better than the main bitch. So this is not a poem. It's a wish for love poem. Because I'm not sure if I've ever had real love, that notebook love, that stupid decision love, that unexplainable yet so far from attainable love. So this is not a love poem. It's a wish for love poem. Because I wish I had a love like the way that the Crips love the word cuz. I wish I had a love like the love that OJ had the moment that his hand didn't fit in the glove. I wish I had a love like the love between a ratchet bitch and her Uggs. I wish I had a love like how a hillbilly loves the sticks, or how rich black men love dating white chicks, or how a dope fiend loves the moment that he finds the money to get his next fix. I wish for a love stronger than the way that Spike Lee loves the Knicks. That no matter what happens, the consistency has never changed from back then. He's still standing on the sidelines, even when I'm throwing bricks, cheering me on, wearing my merch, going, that's my chick. Yeah, I wish for that kind of love. So this is not a love poem. This is a wish for love poem. I wish for you to love me like Kanye fans love their Yeezys. Or even like Kanye loves Kanye, because when he's looking in the mirror going, it's the me for me. I wish I had a love like Patty had from Doug, the damsel in distress in his daydreams, waiting to be saved by my knight and tidy whites, just so he can hear me say, oh, Quail Man, you're my hero. I wish for a love that could break generational curses, like when Stanley Yelnats carried up that boy Zero. So unfortunately, this is not a love poem. It's a wish for love poem. Because I'm really still wishing for love for myself. Yet I'm searching for it in everybody else. So guys, that was Wishes for Love by me, Mika J. Woods. And this is the end of our show. Now, in the next coming week, you guys can find me at Star Bar on Wednesday for Once Upon a Time in Brooklyn. You can also catch me on the 27th with Jamora, who is the daughter of, she's this amazing playwright. And she's doing a tea on the 27th, and I'll be performing there, as well as many, many, many various shows around New York City. I'm always performing, so make sure you follow me on Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, and all the other things, all other social medias. I'm Mika J. Woods. Our show is called The Hungry Poets TV, and the only thing I have left to say to you is, have you fed your soul today? Tune in next month, where our guest will be June Morris, and we will have another featured artist for you, as well as another meal of the month and another dining out on the dine segment. I appreciate you for tuning in. I thank you, and I love you all. Peace, blessings, and love. And make sure to take time to feed your soul this month. Have a blessed day, y'all.
Fed your soul.